Hey there, YouTube. This is eListy68, and I'm providing you guys an updated video for the Sega Arsenal AK that I've been working on. This video is for all you AK lovers. I am recently become a big fan of these weapons, and what I've been working on over the last few weeks is I took a Sega Arsenal and did some modifications to it. First two things I did was put on this new Ergo Grip, and love this grip, super comfortable. And then I had a previous video that gave a product review and overview of the Voltor adjustable stock, and this is the stock that's on there now. It's a great stock, highly adjustable with the Magpul CTR stock on the buffer tube. So what I wanted to show you was another mod that I made, and that is the Midwest Industries quad rail. As you can see here, what I did was I removed the old quad rail, or the old handguard actually, and have installed the aftermarket Midwest Industries handguard. I'll tell you, one thing you have to know about Arsenal, Sega Arsenals, is that you want to be able, when you want to put one of these on here, you want to make sure you order the universal mount. I made the mistake of ordering the Sega mount, but it's for the unmodified version of the rifle, and it didn't fit. So what I had to do was reorder the new one and get a universal mount. So what you see here is the mount itself. As you can see, it is extremely, extremely attractive on this gun. I love the way it made it look. It's now got a really great tactical look to it. It already had a pretty aggressive look, but what I did was I mounted the Midwest Industries handguard. It took me about 20 minutes. I had to take off the old plastic handguard and then bolted on the new one. The other thing I also did was added a couple of new things too. One is I put the Magpul handrest. Don't know exactly the name of this product, but it's by Magpul. Makes it ergonomically just a great fit for me, and set up just exactly how I liked it. Another thing I also did was, if you see on the front here, the old sling mount really was not useful or functional once I put the quad rail on. You can't even snap hook a sling mount to the old sling mount. So I took it off, as you can see there, and I've since created or bought a Voltor bolt-on sling mount to the rail. Actually like the setup. It's got a bunch of flexibility around its type of connection points. It's of course got the claw hook connection point here. That's the one I've chosen. It also has the ability to go right through this area as just the strap itself, or you can put on a, I think it's a maritime snap swivel, I think is what they used to call those. If I'm wrong, correct me, but I believe it was the quick disconnect snap swivel. And then it has another snap swivel capability on the rear. So really a universal mount, but I ended up choosing this one just because I liked the way it fit on the gun. It had a lot more flexibility for me to use maybe on other weapons, and quite frankly, like the way it looks. So pretty much done with this. Not going to make any more changes to the gun. It is still an AK by Sega, but I've made it personal with my modifications. The sling I put on here is the Viking Tactical sling. It's fully adjustable, and it's a two-point sling, and love the way it fits on me, and the way it also is adjustable to do tighten it closer to my body when I'm shooting, or to be able to adjust it for more stability. So just thought I would give you guys an overview. I'll do a little roundabout look on the other side. This is an underside view of the rail system. Oh, I slapped on these plastic rail guards because it just kind of made it a little less sharp to hold on to, and it's absolutely awesome. So anyway, love your feedback. If you have any comments, please post them. But this is the final modification I'm making to my Sega, and potentially looking at another AK. The one I'm looking for right now is a milled receiver AK, and I think I'm going to leave that one all stock if I end up getting it. So look forward to your comments. Hope you enjoy the video. If you have any questions about mounting this thing, let me know. All I can tell you is be patient, take your time. And don't over tighten the rail mount. Thanks. Bye.